We know how we can compute the eigenvectors of a matrix if we know the eigenvalues. But how can we compute the eigenvalues of a matrix A if we do not know the eigenvectors? You will learn the general procedure in this video, and you will also see an explicit example of the computation of the eigenvalues of a 2x2 matrix. So, suppose A is an n by n matrix, V an eigenvector and lambda an eigenvalue. We don't know them yet, but we do know that A times V has to be equal to lambda times V, where both V and lambda are unknowns, and we know that V is not a zero vector. Now, we do the same trick we do quite often. We insert an identity matrix over here. So we know A times V equals lambda times identity matrix times V. We bring this one to the left, so we get A times V minus lambda times identity matrix times V equals zero, and then we can factor out A minus lambda times the identity matrix. And now let's set, just for convenience, B to the matrix A minus lambda times IN. So we define a new matrix B as A minus lambda times IN. Then I know, of course, that B times V equals zero. Now suppose this matrix B is invertible. So B is either invertible or not, but so let's suppose it is invertible. Then I have an inverse B inverse, and then I can put it to the left on both sides of the equation. So we get B inverse times B times V equals B inverse times the zero vector. Well, B inverse times zero vector is of course a zero vector, and B inverse and B will cancel out. So we end up with V equals a zero vector. Hey, but that's not allowed. V can be any vector, but not a zero vector. So that means that our assumption B is invertible is in fact incorrect, because that leads to the V equals zero vector only. So that means that our assumption is incorrect, and the conclusion is that V is not invertible. But now we have a really nice theorem about that. A matrix is invertible even only if its determinant is non-zero. Now we conclude that B is not invertible, so that means that the determinant of B has to be zero. And now we insert back what B was. That means that the determinant of the matrix A minus lambda identity matrix equals zero. And how does that help us? Well, we started with the equation which contained two unknowns, the lambda and the V. But now we have done some manipulations, and we are now at an equation which contains only one of the unknowns. Only the lambda is unknown in this equation over here. So we can use this equation with the determinants to compute our lambdas, as we'll see in the following example. So we have our matrix A here, 1, 3, 3, 1. And suppose I want to compute the lambdas. So what do we need to do? First, I compute A minus lambda times identity matrix here, 2x2 matrix. So A minus lambda times identity matrix. So off diagonal, nothing happens. And on the diagonal, we subtract the lambdas. And now, for lambda to be an eigenvalue, the determinant of this matrix has to be zero. So I compute the determinant. We get 1 minus lambda times 1 minus lambda, minus 3 times minus 3 equals minus 9. So there we are. And if you want, you can work out the brackets. You get 1 times 1 and 1 minus 9 equals a minus 8. The minus lambda minus lambda minus 2 lambda, and lambda times lambda equals lambda squared. So there we are. Now we will introduce several names. This polynomial you will get, the determinant of A and minus lambda times identity matrix, is called the characteristic polynomial of the matrix P lambda. Well, if you want to have eigenvalues, you need to have the zeros of this polynomial, and that's what's called the characteristic equation of the matrix. So that's an equation in terms of lambda, and the eigenvalues are the zeros of this characteristic equation, the zeros of the polynomial, or the solutions of the characteristic equation. Well, we can factorize, of course, and lambda minus 4 times lambda plus 2 equals 0. So we find out lambda equals minus 2 and lambda equals 4. So now you see how you can find the eigenvalues of a matrix. Compute A minus lambda times identity matrix, compute the determinant of that matrix, compute the zeros of the corresponding polynomial, and there you have your eigenvalues.